I am Anand Chokkalingam. I am an associate professor of cardiology at the University of Missouri in Columbia. I have just presented my research on heartful living program for improving cardiovascular health through improving self-awareness at the International Academy of Cardiology Annual Scientific Sessions 2018. The gist of what we are doing, I'll explain in the next few minutes. Over the last 10 to 15 years, we are seeing the increasing awareness among people about heart disease and the impact of the mind on it. This is a very important area because even today, one-third of cardiac patients before calling for medical help lose their lives. Only the two-thirds that have the time to recognize symptoms, call 911, they end up getting medical attention. So to effectively improve the mortality of cardiac disease, prevention plays a key role. And my work in the last 10 years in Missouri has shown that we can effectively sustain the needed lifestyle changes through improving self-awareness. What I mean by this is taking a detailed clinical assessment where we understand the patient's long-term goals, their motivations, their family and surroundings, and come up with a plan where they are able to gradually but sustain significant lifestyle changes. This includes avoiding smoking, increasing exercise, changing diet, and compliance with medications, avoiding stress, relaxation techniques, and all these things become too burdensome if you try to add one on top of the other. But by emphasizing a holistic approach where we encourage patients to pay more attention to things that bring them pleasure on a regular basis, give them satisfaction, give them meaning in life, whether they are 20 years old, 50 years old, or 90 years old, still there are things that are meaningful to them. So we want to encourage people to find meaning in their life, in that day, and through that find the energy to make these changes. So this is the gist of the program. What I'd like to emphasize is for our veterans, the VA system has been doing a wonderful initiative in the last 3 to 5 years called the Whole Health Initiative, Patient-Centered Care, where the emphasis is shifting from advanced technologies to giving more and more responsibility and initiative to the patient and their families towards their health. So I partnered with our VA to bring this program to our veterans, and right across the street is our university hospital where we are offering the same program to the Columbia community, and we find excellent results in the people who are willing to try these holistic measures. So this, I believe, is going to play a bigger and bigger role in the care of cardiac patients. To summarize, I would like to say, as for the individual, try to smile more. I emphasize smiling 20 times every hour if you can. And the way to do that would be through connecting with your own sense of gratitude and fulfillment in that day and in that moment. Relax more. Find things that are more fun, that you don't have to go and exercise in the gym. You could find things that you can do with friends and family out in the parks or in the shopping mall where you can exercise during the winter months, things like that. And diet is not something you avoid in food. It's by enjoying food more, celebrating food more, being present there mindfully and celebrating the food. That way it's not in the quantity but in the quality of the experience that you get the benefit. So these are the things that we emphasize, and I would like to remind people to think about these things in improving the cardiac health of your patients.